Hi friends, welcome to the KD Kaluarachchi. Greeting for a cheerful day for everyone. I usually do my presentations in Sinhala with English subtitles, but this time I just wanted to communicate my message with a wide community base in the world, because I hope the tasks I do will be important for the people who live around earthquake-prone areas. Not only that, earthquakes can be occurred anytime anywhere in the world. Only difference is some areas facing earthquakes very often, where earthquakes return frequency is very high and some areas low. The people who live near very often earthquake-prone areas know how to survive, and they have already taken various type of precautionary measures. They are expecting an earthquake anytime and taken all precautions to minimize the fatality and damage. Most dangerous cases, the areas where earthquakes happen very rarely are experience high number of fatality and damage. No scientist can nominate and certify an area in the world as where earthquake never occurs. Hence, the precautionary standard to be maintained proportionally anywhere in the world. Earthquakes are natural phenomenon. It doesn't harm people. Only the human-made structures harm themselves. Without taking more time, let's go to the topic. I'm K.D. Kaluarachchi, an independent geological researcher from Sri Lanka. Today, the world is in high position in terms of science and technology. But all the scientists in a position that there is no way to predict earthquakes that claim average 27,000 lives a year worldwide. A large number of human lives have been saved so far by early warning about weather changes such as cyclone, thunderstorm, tornadoes and heavy rains. But not being able to make prior warning system about the earthquake is a problem. So far, in many different ways, scientists have tried to identify ways to detect earthquakes in advance. But none of that ways seems to be successful. There are geniuses in the world trying to predict earthquakes with the help of planetary geometric or other mechanism. But it's a question that quality of the prediction were able to save the human lives. Based on this situation, since about 15 years, I was trying to find a way to detect earthquakes before they happen. And I studied in various aspects. As a result, I could identify a way to detect them with the help of atmospheric activities and topographical features on the Earth's surface. The mechanism is similar to what 2500 years ago, the Lord Buddha had a preach called Bhumichala Suthra. The meaning of that name is the earthquake mechanism. In the preach, there were 8 theories reasoning a great earthquake. According to the Lord Buddha, the first theory is a very scientific reason. In a nutshell, the earth rests on fluid. Fluid rests on air. Air rests on space. When a great wind blows, fluid shakes. Fluid shakes the earth crust. Let's fly outside the earth to see this theory. Then you can see the atmosphere settled on space. Next, the fluid settled on atmosphere. Then earth crust settled above and below both way on fluid, known as water and magma. I will give one example to understand. We'll pour some water on a rubber bowl. Then we can say there is water on the bowl. Next step, just throw that bowl into the water. Then can we say that there is water on the bowl? No, we have to say that the bowl is on the water. Likewise, we cannot say that the space located on the earth, although the earth located on the space. That mechanism was explained in such way. When a great wind blows, fluid shakes the earth crust. Great wind need to be understood as the atmospheric anomalies. How does it shake water? When wind keeps blowing in one direction, seawater follows the way. What makes seawater level to slightly rise on one side? By making additional force on ocean bottom with the millions of metric tons of additional weight. At the same time, the other side will decrease the stress. This causes tectonic plates to collide each other due to the reciprocating motion. This collision we know as the earthquakes. According to my analysis, 90% of the earthquakes occurring due to this reason. What I do is identify such conditions to understand the forthcoming earthquakes. I already have started worldwide earthquake prediction on my YouTube channel, mainly on community posts and my KD Kaluarachchi Facebook page. Please follow the link in description field, like the page to follow the daily updates. I have summarized below how you need to understand my predictions. Atmospheric anomaly focusing area. A probability of occurring earthquakes within or close by area according to the fault stress incremental level. The anomaly impact in time duration. A probability of occurring earthquakes within or in a very close by day. The expected intensity level. That was analyzed based on historical activities and earthquake return period analysis. It was given as it is helpful for you to take an idea. But the actual event intensity can be higher in some cases. I am further studying on developing the forecasting level. Although a few percent of the bigger earthquakes could be occur without any recognizable clues. Finally, I request from you all to keep in touch with my YouTube channel videos, community posts and Facebook posts for daily updates. That's all for today. Have a good day for all. Thank you very much. Until the next time.